I would come into the hospital. I'd be pushing a wheelchair with Tim in it, and the twins would be walking beside me on crutches. And usually I was crying. I just feel like I cried all the time in those years because I had three children who wanted so much to run and play and lead normal lives, and that was just never an option for them.
Tim Prevou had his first arthritis symptoms when he was 3 months old. A few years later, his younger brothers Paul and Jacob also began showing signs of the disease. But it took years for doctors to connect their illness to their family's extensive history with arthritis. That discovery came after the Prevou brothers began treatment for what was then called juvenile rheumatoid arthritis at Texas Scottish Rite Hospital for Children.
The doctors did not believe that arthritis was hereditary at that point in 1989. That was not a general understanding. So they just kept saying, there's no way. Just because his father had arthritis, there's no way that he has arthritis.
When you got to family history, it became apparent that not only did Tim have an arthritis that was unusual like this, but that both of his brothers had it, his father had it, his father's sister had it, and her children had it, and the paternal grandmother had it. So at the end of the visit, what I was able to tell the family is, he does not have JRA. I don't know what he has, but what he has is autosomal dominant, meaning that there's going to be a gene involved in this, and that we likely could pursue that.
We did not get real diagnosis until we came to Scottish Rite. Dr. Carol Weiss, the geneticist, and Dr. Virginia Pasquale, an immunologist and researcher, and Dr. Pinero, all three together, really put their heads together, did research together. Dr. Carol Weiss discovered the gene from the blood work she took, not just from my family, my immediate family, but also from my husband's extended family.
As it turned out, the genetic study turned up something very specific that is now in the books called PAPA syndrome.
PAPA syndrome turned out to be a Prevou family disease, but no other member had ever had as serious a case as Tim's. He experienced almost constant pain, and the steroids that were used to treat the pain stunted his growth.
We don't want to just treat and treat and treat. We want to understand what causes diseases, because that's step one to improving the treatment and to ultimately curing a disease. And it's a team approach. You know, once we decide that there is something we can do from a research perspective, everybody on the team pitches in and makes it happen.
Once Dr. Wise and her team of geneticists determined that the Prevous were suffering from PAPA syndrome, their work turned to finding an effective treatment.
They started looking at what medications were available that could block or completely shut down that defective gene process.
In our case, the magic drug was a daily injectable called Kineret.
It was like night and day. It was just an amazing change, especially for the twins.
The therapy with Scottish Rite enabled me to start getting more physically active because it allowed me to have a little bit more faith in what my body could do. It allowed me to see that I wasn't just gonna be some kid in a sick bed all day, every day, for the rest of my life.
By the time I was 10 years old, 11 years old, the barriers were just coming down, and my life was changing for the better every day. And, you know, at this point, I kind of feel like Superman. Just, you know, there's nothing that can really stop me.
My hope is that go to college and learn how to relate to other kids or people having, you know, going through life with chronic illness, and telling them, there's hope.
Tim and his brothers are now in college and have received legacy scholarships from Texas Scottish Rite Hospital for Children.
From the beginning, from the first day we walked through the doors of that hospital, we were enveloped in this tremendous spirit of family. We were just embraced by every single person that we encountered. I can't imagine there'd be any other hospital system, any place else in the world, that would have gone to the lengths that our friends at Scottish Rite went to help us.